All right, I'm back. We stopped the video exactly here in the previous episode. If you're watching the series from this episode, this is the wrong one. Go back, watch that, and come here again. By the way, ignore this error here. We don't want to learn that. We would just want to talk about assembly only. I told you that I want to assign some mates in between this component and this zoom ring. So by the time I rotate this, this component goes back and forth like the final version that I showed you, like this. By the way, you can see my shortcuts, Control Tab jumps between the windows in SOLIDWORKS. The way to do this is to actually create the mechanism for it first, which I have already done. If you download the components, you see inside this component, which I'm gonna open isolated in the part mode by one time clicking on it and click on open part. Now I go to the zoom ring and every adjustment I do to this component will be updated in the assembly mode. If you don't believe me, I'm gonna take it easy on you and change its color first things first and make it go in a different color. Give me a second, don't worry about it. I will fix this for you. Yeah, doesn't matter. So I just changed its color. I'm gonna save it. Hopefully it just updates in the assembly mode as well. Look, inside we have a spiral link, this long, and do we have anything else? No, that's it. That's all we have. So let's just go back. This color is adjusted. And we have one pin on this part here. And we have another pin, if I find it would be nice, here. So one pin here and the other pin here. Two pins, right? One at the end, one somewhere in the middle. I want to assign two different set of mates on each of these individual pins to connect them onto this path over here and onto this slot over here. So one pin can only move inside this slot. The other pin follows this path as you rotate it. So it's like a helix. So when I rotate it, it just pushes it forward without rotating this component. And these are considered advanced mate as well as mechanical mate. I'm gonna take one of each for this example. We go to mate and we wanna go to the mechanical first, pick slot. And the first pin on the back, select the round surface around it, the cylindrical surface, and rotate the angle, select the inner surface of the slot. So immediately SOLIDWORKS notices that, okay, this pin has to go inside the slot, and it gives you a constraint combined menu, which allows you to make them free. That is, it's free to move back and forth, which is what we want, or put it in the center, or give percentage or millimeters of, okay, you want it to be 10 millimeters from the end, it moves there. It moves there. If you want it to be at a 25% from the beginning, it comes here. But we don't want any of that. We just want free and we don't want to lock rotation. Doesn't make any sense at this point. We click okay. Okay. So first thing first, done. My name is Aryan and this is what I do. Baby, this can only go back and forth as long as the length of the slot. See, I cannot even go back, I cannot go further than this. This is my limit. Now next, we want to connect this pin on this spiral, which is a little bit more challenging. Right clicking on this component, I see the menu, and I don't want to click on hide component. I want to click on the icon next to it, change transparency. It makes it see-through, so I see where is what. This is the pin that I have, and this is the path that I want to use. To make sure that you get it right, this is what you get, right? This is a path, which is only a trace. It's not a bump or a cavity. I just created a trace on the flat surface. And it has two struts, the thinner strut and the thicker strut. We just want to select this edge on the thicker strut, the one that is in the middle from this edge and this edge. You see that? If you take these two lines The line exactly in the middle of these two is this one, the orange one. So we want to select this. This is going to be our path. And for that, I have to show you how the path mate works. We go to the mate, we go to the advanced tab, and this time we want to work with path mate. For the path mate, you need a vertex on your very first component and a path on your second component, all right? And it has more than one constraint, which I will talk about in a sec. But I cannot select a cylindrical surface or a flat surface or an edge or anything else. I need to select a point in this case, or at least I want to select a point. And where does that point come from? I have already thought about it. This is what you should do. You click on this component on the inner lens, you open it in the isolated view, and on the design tree over here, the last one is called sketch number 32. Click on it and you click on show. Once you do that, you will see some center lines like this, and this point here, not the top one, this one is the vertex that I want to use to assign the mate to. So control tab back to the assembly, and I see this is the point that I wanted to select, right? Going to the mate, going to the advanced tab, selecting path mate, selecting this point. Oh, the path is wrong. And selecting the path that I told you to select. Let's just zoom in. The thinner strut, the thicker strut, and the inner line. So we select this one. If it didn't select it, press escape, come back because they moved or something happened. So let's do it again. Go to mate. Go to the advanced mate, go to path, zoom in, carefully pick this point, rotate the angle, and pick this edge. Now they move together, and this point is now on that edge. Now, what I can do is to, just like slot, assign a percentage along the path, or a distance along the path, or leave them free. Roll control is the factor that it rolls around it, but none of that makes sense in our example, because this is one component that has two different pins. If I allow this one to rotate, the other pin stops it from rotating, so it's a moot point. We just click on OK, and we are done. But the transparency needs to be fixed again, so right click, change the transparency back to opaque. Now if I rotate the zoom ring, it moves back and forth. The reason it's jumpy is because it has so many small gears, probably over 380, and it's difficult for the preview in SOLIDWORKS. Once you do a render, it will be smooth, I guarantee you that, but right now it's a little bit jumpy. Look, if I do it slowly, there is no jump. See, I rotate this line and the zoom ring goes in. If you want to get rid of the sketch, just select it and click on hide on the menu that pops up next to it. Now you have your camera, which is functioning, and rotating the zoom ring zooms it back and forth like that. Done. By the way, this is the exact lens that I'm using to record myself right now, so you know what kind of lens I'm using. All right, I told you we want to end up somewhere here. We want to assign a gear next to it that by rotating the gear, it works as well. So we need to assign a gear mate as well. We don't need this window, so we can close it, save it, don't save it, I don't care. And go to this tab. Now we go to insert component, browse it, and bring the lens gear. Now I can use this time to rotate it and leave it here. Right. It's still floating. It's all good and fine. Things that I know I want to do. I know this surface and this surface have to be aligned like this. So I select them. I can select them beforehand and then click on the mate tab, and SOLIDWORKS does the mating for you. It makes them coincident. Yes, that's what I want. And I want them to be closer to each other as well, because if we zoom, they have teeth. But it doesn't work like that. It's not like if you place the teeth perfectly into each other. Look, we have a collision here. This is only for preview for SOLIDWORKS. SOLIDWORKS doesn't care if your gear teeth are going inside each other or not. It's not actually working because they push each other. They work as a gear, or your gearbox or assembly of gears in SolidWorks functions because of the gear mate that you assign to it. You could assign it to absolutely two flat cylindrical surfaces and they still work like a gear. So you don't need the teeth. But if you design the teeth in the right way, they obviously follow the rule and it looks perfect. I, on the other hand, did not create these gears perfectly. I just counted the number of gears on my lens and just added that number here. And it's just optical, okay? So don't take me accountable on that. They will collide. Anyways. It cannot go back and forth. We just made this surface and this surface coincident. That's fine and good, but it's far from finished. It can be moved up and down as well as left and right. So what else can we do is we can assign some distance to it, right? If we go to mate, select this cylindrical surface and this flat surface and click on distance, it just pushes it back where it was or wasn't. In this case, maybe it was like this or this. Yep. What did I do? It was set on center to center. I changed it to mean distance, right? Is that minimum distance. That is the distance between this flat surface and not the center of the shaft and not the maximum point, but the minimum. So stays here where it should be. And I'm going to do the same from the top one. So we take care of the other one again. Distance, minimum, and I believe all I can do now is to rotate it. Yes. All right, by rotating this, this component also moved, which is not what we want. We don't want, look, when I rotate this lens gear, this doesn't move, but when I rotate this one, I saw some movement in the lens. See, this is not cool. And the reason it's not cool is because I haven't assigned the gear mate, and while it moves, it's out of my control. So instead of that, I'm gonna go back, open mates, and find the mate that is causing the problem, which is this coincident. I'm gonna right click on it and delete it. And instead, I'm gonna connect this shaft to the body of my camera. So there is no relation between this and this. So now if I rotate it, the lens should be completely neutral, right? That's what I want. The only mate that should connect these two together should be the gear mate. We go to mate, we go to the mechanical tab. We don't want cam, slot, hinge, or others. We want gear. I'm gonna select something random. Technically and officially, if you wanna assign the right gear mate, you have to select the pitch diameter on each gear. And the pitch diameter is not something you would see. You would only use that when you're drawing that gear, right? It ends up somewhere in the mid height of your teeth on the gear. And just like I did the path mate a couple of minutes ago, when you wanna assign the gear mate, you will open your gear in the part mode and you go make that sketch which has the pitch diameter on it shown, and you select that sketch. But in this case, I want to just select this edge here on the first component and this edge here on the second component. Based on the diameter that I select, SolidWorks calculates the ratio 31:50. Sure, let's accept that and click OK. And now if I rotate this gear, it moves the lens with it. See? Very slowly, just so you see, like this. Now the position of the teeth are not so good. They are not engaged into each other. But if I did the distance a little bit more calculated, then it would also look good. Anyways, this is how you can work with SolidWorks assembly for beginners. There is a ton of stuff that I haven't covered. And for covering that, I need way more than 1 hour. I have done this in my course. We're not finished with this series. There will be a next episode, but just so you know, I have a course about 20 hours that I cover every point in SolidWorks step by step. I build up on top of it. And if you're interested in learning it all the way through, go check it out, link in the description below. In the next video, I want to show you how to create an animation in SolidWorks. That is a video, like it collapses and so on and so forth. But before you go and watch the next episode, make sure to check out my webinar, because I cover the 10 common mistakes every SolidWorks beginners make, and I'm sure you're making at the very least 7 of those 10 mistakes, and it wastes a lot of your time. These mistakes that you are doing, a lot of them, are causing you to waste time, because these are the result of building bad modeling habits, and I want to fix it right there and there for you. It's free, just like you went and downloaded these components, you can get that webinar as well, okay?